How y'all doing? Welcome to Rant and Chill or Game and Chill here. I'm hearing myself. Gotta mute that stream there. Wow. Okay. Anyway, gonna be reacting to the Nemophila Revive album, the first studio album by Nemophila, which is great, awesome. Now, of course, they've been around for a little while, right? We've been covering them for a little while, right? Very much like the band. Think they're really good. Mayu has great energy. Saki's great. The band is all around good. I failed to mention the other members. Tamu on the drums, great. Haraguchi, the bass player, happiest rhythm section in any band. Let's see. And Hazuki, the other guitarist. Altogether, I think these ladies create a, I think they're a good recipe together. I think they have really great chemistry, and they have put out really good songs. Some that are very explosive, that get your attention right from the get-go. I think a lot of them do. They get your attention, and they hold it, okay? And they deliver. Especially with Saki and Hazuki, they're going to be providing solos for those who like that sort of thing. What I'm saying is they're going to give you, they're not just going to hold your, get your attention. They're going to keep it, sustain it, and deliver it with everything you expect, plus more. And this is their first studio album. Now, I know they had an EP out and a couple of singles. Some of the songs we react to off this album, we probably already heard before. So, there is that. But, you know, reacting to something that you already like is, hey, that's not a bad thing. All right, so let's go ahead and get this started here. So I have the album art here. I'm going to go ahead and press play very soon, starting from the first track. Now, for those who've already checked out this album, what is your favorite song on this album? You can only choose three. Okay, three songs. And the rest just go away and gone forever. Okay, you can only choose three. What three would they be? Now, this album has a total of 11 songs on it. Revive, Dissension, Hozuki, Hypnosis, Game Over. Game Over, I have not heard before. That seems new. Life. So Rye. Roland. Is that like a Limp Bizkit reference? What? Change the World, Riotai, and this one, Oiran. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and get this started here with Revive. Now, while this happens, because I don't want to just sit here and bob my head and react to it, because as the music plays, I'm probably not going to say much. I'm going to wait until the song is done. I could sit here and do nothing, and we just kind of chill with it. But, you know, I'll play something that'll keep my, that won't be too much of a distraction for me, like Command and Conquer, old school Command and Conquer. That should be fine. Anyway, so let's go ahead and get this started here, all right? Okay. Let me go ahead and change something on the screen here. Okay, and we're going to go ahead and play. We're going to start with Revive with this track number one. Oh, and let me kill the background music here. Here we go. This song's good. I like that they start off with this song. Yes. Okay, so that was Revive, the track Revive. That is a great track to start off with. It is very aggressive. It gets your attention right from the beginning. You know, I had a funny feeling this was going to be like an intro track. Just the way the song started with that nice, like, it's not all, like, that nice little sound in the beginning. That little chorus buildup. Nice. I like it. It's like the wind is coming. You know, like you're hearing these faint sounds. You're hearing the shredding guitar very faintly. Something's coming. What is it? And Revive has that energy, man. Strong, potent energy. Hits you right in the face. High octane. Dude, that's music. You have blasts. You play loud. And you ride crazy. Okay, you drive crazy. Good song. Awesome shredding. And then it opens to a great chorus. That's nice, powerful, keeps you moving, you know, the blood pumping and all that. Good stuff. Now, from Revive, you have a dissension. Now, remember, you can only choose three, the top three. Okay, out of after we listen to all this, only three you could choose as your favorite. The rest just have to go bye-bye. You have to make that tough decision. What would it be? All right, Dissension is next. Let's go ahead and give it a go. What's up, Edward? I'll tell you what I'm thinking about Harvard now. Okay. That was Dissension. That track is really good. That track is really powerful. Now, like I said, some of these songs you've already heard before, because what Dimmafila has been doing, of course, on their YouTube channel, they've been very forthright. I mean, very giving, very generous in showing what they've been working on. Maybe a little too giving, now I'm thinking about it, because a lot of these tracks we've already listened to before. You know, it's good to have maybe like a couple, but then have something else too, you know, have something like, hey, you haven't heard this before. But with that said, I definitely very much enjoy listening to this song again. Dissension is a great song. It has a nice, very fast guitar in the beginning. That riff that she's playing, and I say she, Saki, is really nice. Of course, Tanizaki helps with that too. Which, by the way, during the solo part, can you tell which one is playing what? Do you know? If you watched the music video, you know. But if you didn't know that, can you tell? I'm still bad at that. I don't think I can. I want to say Saki's guitar is a little bit deeper and meatier in sound. I want to say that. Just going based on memory here. But this is the one that has that very cute part where they have a sort of little cute rap thing going on. A very kawaii rap. A little part. I wouldn't really. Is it a rap? It's more like just a kawaii part. I don't know. It's very cute. And it, like, you see them all smiling when they do it in the music video. It's very fun. It's very fun. Good song. So, Dissension is the second track on this album. The next one is Hozuki. Now, let's go ahead and check this song out. Here you go. Ready? 3, 2, 1, let's play. Oh, I'm playing the wrong game for this. I think we'd be playing Quake or something. Yeah. Yeah, I'm playing the wrong game right now. That song is so cool. That song is so cool. Very tight riff, really good stuff. I mean, the hardest thing about this album is going to be the three that he chooses that are going to be your favorites. Right now, I can tell you Revive, Dissension, and Hazuki. Like, these three are good. But down the list, like, we're gonna play some songs. I already know number 11, Oiran. That's going to be on my list. Oh God. But tight riff with thunderous drums. Okay. There you go. Oh man, there is a particular part in this song too that are like, there's the part where they change up the beat a bit and kind of has more like a hip hop sound to it. I really like that. And then here's that riff. Here we go. The way Mayu's singing right there, man. And it's like, are you whispering in my ear right now? Are you telling me something? I'm a married man. Are you telling me something? You got my attention. And it just opens up, man. They're really good at the structure with their songs, I gotta say. Next one is Hypnosis. Now, last time I did a reaction on this, you know, I liked the song, but I wasn't like in love with it, you know. It wasn't my favorite. But here we go. What do y'all think? Do you think Hypnosis is gonna be on your top three? You can only choose three. Make it challenging. It has to hurt a little. That's what's so hard about that three. Next song, Hypnosis. Well, what was it doing? Okay. Wait. That's Hazuki. Okay, here's Hypnosis. There we go. YouTube Music. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. Now this is appropriate. I should be playing Command & Conquer Generals, GLA. Come on.
Thank you.
drum solo. Tamu tearing it up. That song probably has the most unique sound on this whole album. That song is not a bad song. It's actually pretty good. I understand why people in the comment section on that reaction video were not necessarily enthused by what I said. It is a good track, and hearing again, I can hear a lot of things that really make it stand out against Revive and Dissension and Hazuki. Whereas Revive is very aggressive, Dissension 2, Dissension kind of blends in a little bit more with a kawaii element into it. Hazuki has a little bit more of a little hip-hop part of it. Hypnosis has that, like, Bollywood, like I don't know what to call it other than that sort of, like, India sound. I don't know how to really describe it, really. But it's nice in the whole way, like the way, even the way they layer like Mayu's voice, it goes with the song, right? Very hypnotic, put you in a hypnosis. And yeah, Tamu's drum solo is pretty good. That's really good. And so this song, you really, it's not so much about the aggressive and hard hitting, you know, guitars. It's more stylized. That might make it to my top three favorites of this album. I don't know. What about you? Is it going to be on your top three? We'll see. Next, we have Game Over. Okay. Now, this one, we haven't heard before. This one's new. All right, let's roll it.
Thank you.
Nice. Nice little breakdown. Is a nice track right there. Whoa, that's different. Much slower paced, but very chill, deep. There's some depth to that song there. I like the tone of this guitar. Oh, of course, Mayu's voice is just dead on, man. See, that's the thing. Mayu has great range. I mean, she can go from singing and just screaming and, you know, all that stuff. But anyway. Nice little slide stuff going on there. That's good. Very powerful in how it builds up. I like that. Now, the part that really got me, though, I think was towards, like, the middle. Now the song gets a little bit of that crunch sound, you know? It's a little aggressive. Like the gloves are off. Oh, and there's something here that really caught my ear. That's the part right there where the two guitars are like work on this harmony together. Okay, wait. That's great. That's good stuff. Good stuff. So that's game over. Well, wow. Oh, that's a good song. Good song. All right. Now, next one on the list is Life.
Thank you.
Okay. This song, I think, is underrated. There's a lot of technical stuff going on in this song here. Of course, I'm not a guitar expert. I'm not a guitar guru. But all that stuff you hear in the background, I think a lot of it is definitely produced by the guitar. I mean, I could hear the little hammering-ons, a little fingering action going on there. That sounds like something else. What am I describing here? The song or something else here? But, yeah, I mean, you can hear the guitars working in harmony there. It is not. So far, we're at track number 6. Right, I started off with Revive, which is strong, high octane aggression. Then you had Dissension, which is also very heavy. Hazuki, heavy with thunderous drums. Hypnosis, we change up the flavor of the whole thing. Game Over. Okay, now we're going soft. We're going more like a power ballad. I wouldn't say that's a power ballad, but we're kind of in that territory. Now it's. That's more just light. It's definitely lighter. It's definitely on the softer side. Life is like when I hear this song, I think we're gonna go on an epic journey. We're gonna go on an epic adventure here. This tone with the guitar has a lot of reverb or. Whatever effect it has. That right there, that's not keyboard. That's guitar effects. That's guitar. And you hear that throughout the song. You know, it's like this, it's really cool. It's like, you can hear it and listen to the track. It just kind of like, those notes just sort of like cascade gently, you know, on your eardrums. It feels nice. It feels nice. And is it me? I know they say it's the Revive version. There's something different about the song, especially in the middle. Like the, I remember there being a solo in this song. That's not what I'm like wondering about. It is the intensity of the solo. I think there's something more to it. Maybe it's wrong. Maybe I'm just thinking things, you know, misremembering. Berenstain effect. Maybe not. Maybe the song has always sounded like that. I think so, right? Correct me if I'm wrong there. It's a good song. It is a good song, especially that part to it, man. There's a lot of character. There's a lot of depth to that song. Choosing your top three, man. The three songs you choose from this album to be your top three, and that's it. Then all the other songs that have to go bye-bye in the trash. You never listen to them ever again. That's going to say a lot about your preference here. Because there's definitely some variety. Now, the next one on the list, track number 7, is So Rai. Here we go. You ready? 3, 2, 1, let's jam. Nice, nice. So Rye, So Rye. I think this might have been like the first song I reacted to them. It is a good song. Not my favorite, which is kind of weird because it has the aggression. Well, it doesn't really have the aggression of Revive or Dissension or Hazuki. Not really. Not really. It's pumped. The song has a lot of pumped up energy. This song, when I hear the song, I'm thinking, I got to hear it live. This song would sound great live, especially with that, with the way the chorus is designed. It's like it's designed for feedback from the crowd, you know, like you hear it. Mayu saying so right, and you know the band backs her up on that. That's the crowd. That's supposed to be the crowd, you know, and that's supposed to be on the live album. You know, you'd hear the crowd do that, and that would be that. Make the song, give it a power that the other songs don't necessarily have. They don't really have that moment for that. It's a good arena song. You know, it's a good, if you understand what I'm trying to say there. Good energy to it. Good energy. I got to tell you though, already I can tell you it's not going to be my top three. It's not going to be my top three. It's not the heaviest song on this album, most definitely. And you know, one of my top three is going to be the heaviest. And so far, I think the heaviest on this album, the fastest, I think, is Revive. The heaviest, is it Hazuki? It's so far, it's tied between Hazuki Dissension and Revive. I'm not exactly sure. Anyway, I'll think about that. Meanwhile, let's move on. We have some of the tracks here. We have Rollin'. I hope to God this is not some Limp Bizkit reference. Here we go. Haraguchi? Haraguchi-san on the bass. I'm liking that. Oh, yes. I'm liking everything about this song right now. It's hard, and you have a little techno flair in the background. It's like Gottrick Spin or Dawes Box. Yeah. This is gonna be my top three. Yes, yes, yes. Dude, you got high energy and you got bass slap going on there. You have awesome bass action, high energy, high octane, and little electro flair in the background. This might be one of my favorite tracks on this album so far. I could listen to this a lot. Hypnosis might be your jam. Game Over might be your jam. Those are good songs, don't get me wrong. But this right here... Dude, I'm liking that. I'm liking that track. I'm liking that track. That track is nice. Rolling. Man. Okay. Next up is Change the World. All right. This one I don't think I've heard before. There's a lot of energy in that song. It's not as aggressive as some of the others, but there's a lot of energy in it. You could feel it. I love the little bass. Man, did Nymophila, did they put Haraguchi-san like in a corner? Now, I'm just saying. It seems like to me the tracks I haven't heard, like Rolling, Rolling, Change the World, are the ones I'm hearing some bass stuff that I'm like, wait, where was this at? That's some good stuff. That's some good stuff. Change the World is nice. Interesting. part of me wants to include it on my top three, but I don't think it's going to be one of my top three. You know, the bass parts kind of won me, or trying to win me over. There's some nice energy to the song. I don't know. It's a short song. It's only 3 minutes. I don't know if I could play that on repeat. I could definitely do Rollin' Rollin' for a little bit. You know, Revive is definitely on my top three list. I know that for sure. Revive is locked and loaded and in. Okay? Got two more tracks. Riotay? And then Oiran? I'm horrible with this, with these names. All right. Here we go. So, reminds me of, oh yeah, a little bit. The guitar, anyway. There's some really good energy in this song, man. I like it. What? That sounded pretty awesome. Okay, let me hear this one more time, just the beginning. That particular riff right there, with the way that with the drum pattern, it does remind me. There has a certain song by Hell Yeah that it kind of reminds me a little bit of that. Just a little bit. I like that attitude. I like that aggression there in that song. This song actually kind of blends like the aggression of Revive with the sort of I guess I want to say like the crowd work with a So Rai. Where I said before with So Rai, that song would be great hearing live with the crowd, you know, giving the feedback in that particular part in the chorus where it's clearly that's what it's built for that. Riot has a similar structure to it, but it just has, it's more pumped up. It's good. These girls, they, I gotta say, if you like metal, this album does not disappoint. It does not disappoint. There's more metal on this album than there is anything else, which is what I was expecting, you know? Game Over in Life, Hypnosis, Game Over in Life are the three tracks so far that kind of stand out as like different. Well, Ascension has a, see, there's things about each particular track that's a little bit different from the others. Choosing top three is going to be hard. It's going to be hard. Okay, we're down to Oiran. Here we go. This is Revive version, so let's see if we can notice any difference. Gotta tell you, man, I have a soft spot for the song. You hear that, man? When I say high energy, that's what I'm talking about.
Die!
Dude, that was really nice. A very tight, sharp riff that just slices through. This is one of my favorite songs from Nymophila. It really is. I mean, the way it starts up, and then boom, release. Very similar to Revive, right? And then release that scream, girl. And then you think you're going to get something nice. Oh, you hear, oh, it's an all-female band. Oh, it's a female singer. Oh, you think she's going to sing and be nice and delicate. And pfft. Dude, I love how it builds up with that soya. Soya, soya, soya. And it builds up, ramps up, and then it just releases for the chorus. This is like the pre-chorus part. Because one of my favorite parts about this song is coming up. Is it? Oh, it's after the next one. No, no, that's right here, it's right here. Dude, the hammer and drums and all that, the energy, that's like scream at the world with your anger sort of sound, man. I love that. I love that. Man, they start off with a good song. They end with a good song. They start off with a hard song. They end with a hard song. Look at that. Now that I think about it, Oiran and Revive kind of similar structure and energy to it. Okay. But top three off this album here? Well, top three. My three that I would choose. I think you already know what it is. I think you know. What is yours? Let me know in the comment section. All right. Revive, Rollin', and Oiran. So you could say, I mean, those are my top three. That says a lot, I guess, about what I like here. I mean, I like all their songs, but those are the top three. Those are the top three for me. Anyway. Nah, I knew the stream was going to be kind of like this, kind of chill, kind of small. I know a lot of you guys will comment afterwards, as y'all usually do. Could only do this live reaction on Twitch and then put on YouTube and then see what sticks. I think a lot of this will stick. We'll see. The Nymophila girls are very generous for that. You know, a copyright claim is much different than a strike. A claim is, well, to be expected. All right. Well, with that said, y'all take it easy.